Hi, this is Naomi Skorzynski with topshelfva.com. Today we are going to talk about Camtasia's picture-in-picture. I was noticing the other day watching a colleague's video that she had her picture-in-picture, but she had a small little video of herself down in the bottom right-hand corner. She was just using the default. And there are many ways to be able to use the picture-in-picture. You can actually turn it off, move it out of the way, enlarge it, etc. There's various ways that we can use picture-in-picture. So that is what we're going to talk about today.
Now, the first place to start with your picture-in-picture is setting up the recorder correctly. The first thing to do is to select the microphone. If you have more than one microphone, you can choose it from this drop-down selection here. You do not necessarily need to use the webcam microphone if you have others to choose from that may be of better quality. Then turn on your webcam by clicking on it to get a green check mark. You need to set up some options in order to use the picture-in-picture to its ultimate abilities. I have a Logitech C920, so this may be a little different from your setup. Make sure your screen capture is at 30 frames per second. Click on Format Settings. You will see the output size is set at 640 by 480, which is quite small. Click on the drop-down button and select 1280 by 720. Or 1600 by 896, which will still be at 30 frames per second. Then say OK. If you try going to 1920 by 1080, you will notice since Camtasia is recording both, it will relegate 1920 by 1080 to 5 frames per second, which is extremely disjointed. You can check this on your own system, whichever one will work best for you. The main point is to make sure your webcam is recording at 30 frames per second at the largest size possible. Now, if you wanted to change any of the adjustments of your webcam, you could select Device Properties and make the adjustments you needed. Once you have these set, you can then say OK. Then click on Record to start recording your webcam and screen at the same time. Once you are done, click on F10 to stop the recording. Then click on Save and Edit and give the file a name you will remember and save. Your Camtasia will open up with a recording on the tracks. The first track will be your screen capture. The second track is your webcam recording. Always make sure the track you are not currently working on is locked. It's always nice to start off your videos with a bit of a larger image of yourself so that you have more of a connection with your audience. Move your cursor over the webcam video and you will see the cursor changes to a crossed arrow. This would mean if you click and hold your left mouse button down, you could move this anywhere on the canvas you wanted. But what we want to do is expand it, so put your cursor over the left corner. It will turn into a double arrow and start moving it to the opposite corner to expand it. Now keep in mind how you set your options at the beginning for recording will dictate the clarity as you expand. Now you have some choices. Let's say once you have given your greeting around 3 seconds, you want to minimize the webcam video portion back to the corner. To do this, make sure the track is still highlighted. Then click on your Visual Properties tab. If it is not showing, click on More and select it from the drop-down list. Go to the Visual Properties, click on Add Animation. Put your cursor over the corner for the double arrows and decrease the size. You will now see the animation arrow on the track. You can adjust the animation start and end by clicking on the little round circles at either end. You can also move the full arrows on the track to have it last the same amount of time but start in a different location. Now let's say we also want to move in on a specific part of the screen capture at the same time the webcam animation is happening. Lock the webcam track and unlock the screen capture track. Place your playhead at the end of the webcam animation, making sure the screen capture track is selected. Then click on the Zoom In Pan tab. Then zoom in on the location in the screen capture by adjusting the frame in the zoom area. If you need to, adjust the animation arrow so it aligns exactly with the webcam animation. For some pattern interrupt, let's say you want to move the webcam image to the opposite corner. Make sure the screen capture track is locked and the webcam track is unlocked and highlighted. Place your playhead where you want the animation to end. Click on the Visual Properties tab and click on Add Animation. Then move the webcam image up to the other corner. You can come up with a whole variety of ways of using this picture-in-picture in animation features. Let's adjust the animation so it happens relatively quickly, so we'll shorten this as an example. We also want an animation on the screen capture to happen at the same time. We lock the webcam track and unlock the screen capture track and make sure it is highlighted. Then we click on the zoom in pan and zoom into the location we want. We want it to line up with the webcam animation, so we'll adjust the screen capture animation the same way we did previously. Now you may want to make a specific point at one location for emphasis. You want your audience to really see you well. Once again, lock the screen capture track, unlock the webcam track and highlight it. Click on Add Animation and enlarge the webcam video. Now I may want to fully focus on the screen capture and don't want to be on the screen at all. Click on Add Animation, then move your cursor over the webcam image and slide it off to the left. This way the main focus is what is on screen and not on you. Later you may say, I have a main point to add and I want to hide the screen capture video. Here's how you can do that. First, you would start by shrinking the canvas to 25% so you can see everything on the canvas. Make sure your webcam track is highlighted and click on Add Animation. Expand the webcam image so it lines up top and bottom to the main screen height. You can tell this by the yellow lines. What I want to do now is crop this image so only I am showing. You can't see the end here of the webcam image, so you need to be able to move the canvas to the right. What you can do is either click on the hand icon to move the canvas or holding your space bar down while you move the canvas to the right. Now in order to crop this, you can either click on the crop icon or you can hold the Alt key down, which changes these white lines to the blue crop lines. You can then move the webcam image back on screen using the yellow lines as the guidelines. Now all of this is still being recorded by the animation that you clicked a little while back. Let's go back up and shrink to fit so we can see a larger screen. Let's say at this point you wanted to add your key point here to the right of you. Right click on the first track, which is your screen capture track, and select Insert Track Above. Now I've already put a little graphic together in my library for this demonstration. I'll move it down to the empty track next to the playhead. As you can see, there are a variety of ways to use your picture-in-picture feature. Rather than sticking with just a tiny picture in the bottom right corner that stays there all the time. So I hope you've gained a lot of information and tips and tricks from using this picture-in-picture feature. Also, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel to receive more Camtasia how-to videos. Be sure to leave a comment and let me know of any other how-to videos you would like to see. Thank you so much for watching and liking this video. Until we meet again, have a wonderful life.